Hello students, this is the 8th video of module 2. So in the last video I was explaining you about the interface circuits, and there are two different types of ports which can be used in order to interconnect the IO devices with the processor over the bus. So here first we will see what actually is a parallel port, then we will move on to what is a serial port. So first, parallel port, it consists of 8-bit input port and 8-bit output port. Then we can combine together in order to get the general purpose 8-bit parallel port, and we can design it. So we assume that the interface circuit is connected to a 32-bit processor that uses memory mapped I/O and the asynchronous bus protocol. So in the last video I have explained you what actually is asynchronous bus protocol, that is handshake method will be used, and also memory mapped I/O means all the I/O devices will be mapped to the main memory only. So figure in the next slide, it shows the components which are needed to connect the hardware components which are required to connect the keyboard to a processor. A typical keyboard consists of the mechanical switches that are normally open. When a key is pressed, it switches closes and establishes a path for an electrical signal. So this signal is detected by an encoder circuit that generates the ASCII code for the corresponding character. So once we are going to press any character in our keyboard, then what happens is it may be detected multiple number of times, that is the bouncing may occur for a single character. If we are pressing it one time also, it will be showing 2 or 3 times. So in order to avoid or in order to eliminate it, we are going to use the debouncing circuit. So so we can make use of a debouncing circuit which will identify so any duplicate pressing of the key has been done or what, until and unless some time limit has to be passed, or else we can also avoid this by using the software approach, that is some program may be written, some IO routine may be installed within this debouncing circuit, and it may be executed every time a key is being pressed. So this is how we can eliminate the debouncing of the any of the keys. So once we are going to press any of the key, then the output then the encoder, it will encode the characters into the ASCII mode, and it will also set the control signal to valid, that is some key has been pressed and it has to be sent to the buffer. Okay, so that will be indicated by this control signal valid. This information is sent to the interface circuit which contains the data register, data in, and a status flag SIN. So here in the diagram you can see, so this is the diagram. It will be consisting of the keyboard switches. So this is our keyboard, and from here once the key has been pressed, then it will be given to the encoder circuit. So whatever data has been encoded and it has been converted into ASCII code, then that data will be passed to the data register and also SIM flag, indicating that there is some input which has to be given to the processor. So this is about the read operation, how it actually does. So first the address will be mentioned from the processor to this input interface, and the master ready and the read write operation, what operation it requires, either read or write operation, that also will be specified, and whatever address will be mentioned here, that particular address will be checked, and whatever data will be stored at that point that will be transferred from the input interface, that is in the from the data in register. So whatever data will be present, it will be passed to the processor. And also in the meanwhile, once the master ready signal has been sent by the processor, the slave also has to respond with the slave ready signal. So here the handshake method occurs. So this is nothing but the asynchronous protocol has been used here. Okay, so this is about the interface circuit where we are going to use a parallel port. So this is about the input interface. This is about the output interface. Output interface means we are going to connect the printer to the processor. So here how it happens means first the processor will send the data, whatever has to be printed, it will be sending the data and the address location. So data out, it will be consisting of the data which has been sent by the processor, and S out signal will be set such that to indicate the printer that there is some valid data which has to be given to the printer. Along with that, read or write operation also will be maintained. So as this is write operation, so it will be enabled, write operation will be enabled. So master ready and slave ready. So this is the handshake method which is being used. So in this way, the data will be transferred from the processor to the printer, and the output will be given. Okay, so this is about the processor parallel port, and this is how the input interface circuit looks like. So this is starting from keyboard, and we will be having the inverters and also the gates which will be used in order to access the data and also to decode the addresses. Along with that, we'll be having the master ready and slave ready signal along with the read or write operations. So everything will be given here. So output lines of the data in are connected to the data lines of the bus by means of three state drivers. So this is the three state drivers here. So what it does is drivers are turned on when the processor issues a read signal and the address selects this register. A SYN signal is generated using a status flag circuit. It is connected to the line D0 of the processor bus using a three state driver. Address decoder selects the input interface based on the bits A through A31. That is, here we'll be having totally 32-bit address scheme we are using. So all the address lines have to be set. Bit A0 determines whether the status or the data register is to be read. When master ready is active, in response, the processor activates the slave ready signal when either the read status or read data is equal to 1, which depends on the line A0. So A0 is responsible for the to determine whether the status of the data register is either read or write operation has to be performed. So this is about interface circuit, and here we have the diagram which indicates the data out register, data direction register, data direction register. It will be telling the input and output devices in which direction actually the data has to be moved, either from the input processor to the input to the processor or processor to the output device. So along with that, we also have the register select, which register is being activated at that particular point of time. So it will be consisting of my address RS0 to RS2 and register select 0, register select 1, register select 2. Depending on these values, that particular register will be selected, and whatever data will be stored at that particular register, it will be read or written. And ready and accept are the signals which will be used for the processor and the input or output device, whether it is a read or write operation. Status and control flags, it will be consisting of two control lines, and also it will be consisting of the interrupt request line. If any interrupt has to be taking place, then this interrupt signal will be activated. So this is how the diagram look like. And the parallel circuits can be configured in various ways. Data lines P7 through P0 can be used for either input or output purpose. The data out register is connected to three lines via three state drivers that are controlled by a data direction register. The processor can write any 8-bit pattern to DDR for a given bit. If DDR value is 1, the corresponding data line acts as an output line. Otherwise, it acts as an input line. Two lines C1 and C2 are provided to control the interaction between the interface circuit and the I/O device it serves. Line C2 is bidirectional to provide several different connections. So modes of signaling, including the handshake control lines on the processor bus side, and hence would be connected to master ready and slave ready. The input signal, my address, should be connected to the output of an address decoder that recognizes the address assigned to the interface. There are three register select lines allowing up to 8 registers in the interface. Input and output data, data direction and control and status registers for various modes of operation. INTR is also connected on the interrupt request line on the computer bus. So this is the explanation of this diagram. So how it actually takes place. Then moving to the serial port. So I have told you there are two different ports. One is a parallel port, the other one is a serial port. So serial port, actually in serial port we will be transferring one bit of data at a time. So this serial port, its diagram is shown here. So it will be consisting of the input shift register, which will be connected to data in, and the output shift register, which will be connected to the data out. The main function of this shift register is to convert the serially transferred 1 bits to parallel 8 bits. So once the shift register receives all the 8 bits, then it has to send it parallelly to the data in register, and it has to store there. So that work will be taken care by the input shift register and the output shift register. So here, parallel to serial to parallel conversion.